When Geneva Resolution 30/1 spoke about the need to introduce foreign judges to the Sri Lankan judiciary system, that was to establish confidence about the Sri Lankan judiciary system. This is one of the most ridiculous arguments, because Sri Lankan judiciary system is more than 100 years old. It's a time-tested system, and there's absolutely no need for somebody to come and say that the confidence level has to be increased with regard to this system. When you talk about accountability, if anyone has to be held accountable for what happened during the latter part of the war, that has to be two ways. It can't be one way. Now, during the war, we remember how TNA stood with Prabhakaran, supported Prabhakaran, accepted Prabhakaran as the sole representative of the Tamil nation, and acted as the representative of Prabhakaran in the civil society. Anybody who supports terrorism should also be held accountable for the crimes committed by the terrorists. So in that regard, TNA is also very much responsible for the crimes committed by the LTT. So they also have blood in their hands. Now, also when you talk about accountability, you must remember that more than 11,000 LTT cadres were rehabilitated after the war, and the government took a policy decision not to prosecute a single child soldier, and most of these LTT cadres were child soldiers. If they were to be held accountable, half of these people would be in jail even now. But that's not the way Sri Lankan government has acted, and I think that's the way, the right way to go forward, because the hatred can never be appeased by hatred, as Lord Buddha said.